parents, it's Miss P here with the small group activity, and today we are going to be talking about volcanoes. All right, so parents, remember we are trying to get a level 5 in the natural and physical world. We want the child to identify a change in material or the environment and a possible cause. So we're going to learn about volcanoes and their volcanic eruptions. The only thing we need for today's lesson is vinegar and baking soda. All right. A couple fun facts about volcanoes. Volcanoes, they are openings of the Earth's surface. And when the Earth opens up, it can release gas, ash, and magma. Another fun fact. The word volcano, originally comes from Roman god of fire, Vulcan. All right, and one more, last but not least, what else do I know about volcanoes? The hot liquid rock under the Earth's surface that's known as magma. Magma becomes lava once it erupts out of the volcano. Did you know that? We need this baking soda and vinegar. And I want you guys to watch this video and let's jump right into it.
The surface of the Earth, the crust, is comprised of a number of tectonic plates, which are constantly moving slowly at about the rate your fingernails grow. Most volcanic activity occurs at the places where these plates meet, the plate boundaries. The large layer of rock beneath the Earth's crust is called the mantle. This is mostly solid, but in certain places it can melt to become magma. This causes volcanic activity. At mid-ocean ridges, tectonic plates move apart. This creates space for the mantle rock below to rise. As it moves upwards, the pressure on the rock decreases, allowing it to melt. When the magma reaches the surface, the ocean water causes it to cool, creating giant pillow-like formations of a rock called basalt. These rocks make up most of the sea floor. At subduction plate boundaries, a thin oceanic plate slides under a thicker continental plate. The oceanic plate is saturated with water, which it drags down into the earth. At around 60 miles deep, the water trapped inside is released, which reduces the melting point of the surrounding rock, allowing it to melt. This melted rock cools as it rises. Different minerals cool at different rates, and one of the last to cool is silica. The magma which eventually reaches the surface is silica rich, which makes it thick and gloopy. Because the magma is so thick, the gases released on melting get trapped in large bubbles. When one of these reaches the surface, it bursts. This is what causes an explosive volcanic eruption. There are also a number of so-called volcanic hotspots away from plate boundaries. Here, mantle rock is melted by a plume of heat originating from deep in the earth. The Hawaiian Islands were formed over one such hotspot and still contain the world's most active volcano, Kilauea.
All right, guys, so this is literally Miss P's homemade volcano. I took a piece of cardboard as a base and then I used a bunch of different tissue paper and paper cutouts and taped them together. And I used a green tissue paper and then I spray painted it silver to give you more of a volcano look. Inside is a bottle that's inside of here. I'm not sure if you can see it. Maybe now you can see it. And it's filled with baking soda. So now we're gonna add our activator, the vinegar, and we're gonna see what happens. Da 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 da. All right, let's see. Did you guys see? Look at that. Wow. Oh, guys, I would be asking you, what does it smell like? I would be saying, what does it smell like? Because it has a very, very, ooh, look at that. Look at that go.
Smell like onions.
Onion juice. Ooh, volcano eruption! All right, guys. So when we tried the first time, we didn't have much baking soda inside of the water bottle. So make sure that you put enough baking soda inside to make your volcanic eruption erupt. All right. I hope you guys like this video, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.